Everybody's waiting for their one and only, and now and always. And everybody's waiting.
The worst golf chokes and collapses. Choking is something that every golfer, even the greatest golfers, well, except for Jack Nicklaus, does at one time or another. Sometimes the pressure just gets to you and you can't execute the shots you want to hit, or you start making poor decisions. When those breakdowns happen late in big tournaments, they are remembered for a long time to come. The collapses on this list are such animals. The biggest chokes in golf history. Here are our picks for the 10 worst chokes or collapses in golf history. Number 10, Ed Sneed, 1979 Masters. Sneed was a solid player for many years, and the 1979 Masters was his best shot at a major. He began the final round with a 5-stroke lead and kept the lead of at least several strokes through most of the day. Then, things fell apart. With a 3-shot lead and 3 holes to play, Sneed proceeded to bogey the 16th, 17th, and 18th holes. His par putts on 16 and 17 stopped right on the lip. On number 18, Sneed again came agonizingly close. The par would have won him a green jacket, but with the bogey and a 76 total for the 4th round, Sneed fell into a playoff, which he lost to Fuzzy Zeller. Number 9, Lorena Ochoa, 2005 US Women's Open. Ochoa hit one of the worst drives ever at a critical time in a major tournament. It happened on the 18th hole at the 2005 US Women's Open. She had rallied throughout the day from well back and was in a position to win, or at least get into a playoff. The 18th hole at Cherry Hills required the players to aim right, cutting off part of a lake and carrying the ball to the fairway. Ochoa's drive never even sniffed land. Her driver hit the ground a couple inches behind the ball, taking a divot, then bounced up into the ball. The ball shot left and dove into the water. To make matters worse, Ochoa's second drive found the rough, then her approach to the green went into the grandstands. She quadruple bogeyed number 18 and finished 4 shots back. Number 8, Phil Mickelson, 2006 US Open. Mickelson started his career 0 for 46 in majors, then changed his approach. He dialed back the aggression and started making much better course management decisions, and it paid off. He entered the 2006 US Open at winged foot, going for his 4th career major and 3rd in a row, and he almost got it. But then he reverted to his previous form. His driver deserted him all through the final round. He even hit it into a trash can on number 17, yet he kept hitting it, and his decision making deserted him on the final hole. Mickelson had a 1-stroke lead as he stood on the 18th tee. Despite hitting only 2 fairways all day, he pulled the driver again. And again, he missed, only this time, badly. His drive hitting the roof of a hospitality tent and bounding into the spectator area. Mickelson had a decent lie, but a bad idea. Rather than advancing the ball a short distance, but getting back in the fairway, where he might make par the hard way, or at worst, bogey to get into a playoff in which he'd be the heavy favorite, Mickelson attempted a huge slice under and around tree branches. It didn't work. The ball hit a branch and stopped 25 yards in front of him. He hit another big slice, but this one plugged in a back bunker, and not even Mickelson's short game magic could save him from there. He double bogeyed and finished 1 shot out of a playoff. I'm such an idiot, he succinctly said afterward. Number 7, Mark Calcavecchia. 1991 Ryder Cup, one of the more painful collapses to watch, with the Ryder Cup pressure appearing to almost suffocate Calcavecchia's game. Known as the War on the Shore, the 1991 Ryder Cup was intense from the start. The Americans failed to gain the cup in the 3 previous competitions, something Team USA wasn't used to, at that time anyway, and didn't like. A lot of tough rhetoric preceded this Ryder Cup, and tension was heavy throughout. Calcavecchia's singles match was against Colin Montgomery, and Calc looked in great shape. He was dormy, 4 up with 4 to play. A win or even just a half by Calc on any of the final 4 holes would win the cup for America. You know what happened. Calcavecchia lost all 4 holes and halved the match. The stretch included a tee shot in the par 3 17th at the Ocean Course that was very close to a shank, Calcavecchia's ball plopping into the water. That happened after Monty, who was struggling himself, had already put his own tee ball in the water. Amazingly, Calcavecchia reached the 17th green with the chance to have the hole and win the Ryder Cup with a double bogey, but he missed the 2-foot putt. Thinking he had lost the Ryder Cup for Team USA, Calcavecchia walked away from the 18th green, down onto the beach, sank into the sand, and cried. But he was saved from the permanent GOAT status when Bernhard Langer missed a 6-foot par putt on the final hole of the Cup, halving with Hale Irwin and allowing the U.S. to win back the Cup. Number 6, Adam Scott, 2012 British Open. Scott had always been one of those golfers with a sweet swing, consistently good results, and the mystery of why he hadn't yet won a major. He appeared poised to finally get that major at the 2012 British Open, which he opened by shooting 64 in the first round. Scott began the final round with a 4-stroke lead and appeared in control throughout the final round. As he stood on the 15th tee, Scott held a 4-stroke lead and was 5 ahead of Ernie Els. Just after Scott striped the perfect drive on 15, Els, a couple groups ahead, made a birdie on the 16th to get within 4. It all went south from there for Scott. He bogeyed the last 4 holes while Els rallied, including a birdie on the last, to beat Scott by 1. Scott didn't blow up on any of the last 4 holes. He just made simple mistakes on each one. At the 15th, his approach shot found a bunker. On the 16th, he missed a 3-foot par putt. On the 17th, his approach was long and found foot-high rough behind the green. On the 18th, his tee ball rolled into a pot bunker. Scott played out sideways from that bunker, then hit a great approach, but missed the 7-foot par putt that would have forced a playoff.
By myself.